Welcome back to Magic Tarot Cards. It's Jasmine, and I have a five card spread here for you. This is for the zodiac sign of Aquarius. This is your monthly for December 2020. I have pre-shuffled the cards, and we have five cards here for you. Y'all, this is a general reading, so if it doesn't resonate with you, come back for a personal reading. You can contact me in my email in the description box down below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, y'all. Tell your friends about me. I do all kinds of readings. I do missing people, solving crimes, love readings, whatever you want to know, I can do. All right, y'all. And I want to show you this cup. This is one of my Christmas cups. Sorry. It's got a little, let me lift this camera up. It's got a little straw here. It says, better not pout. Isn't this cute? I got this at Walmart. I just think it's the cutest thing. All right. And then this candle is the one that my daughter bought me in October, pumpkin cupcake, and it's almost done. She buys me one every month, so I'm still using this one for the fall. All right, let's get started with the reading, y'all. Remember, this video is not made for kids. If you're under the age of 18, please click off now, and this channel is my brand. Do not attempt to copy my material. Let's get started. Aquarius, okay, you got some stuff going on here, and you're going to have some choices to make, okay? Now, for the first one, we have the Knight of Wands. Okay, so I do see an ex trying to return to you. I'm thinking it's an ex that you might have broken up with. If this happened to you during October when we had the Mercury retrograde, I saw there was a lot of breakups then. And so I'm kind of seeing someone coming back quickly. They're going to kind of rush in and during December and maybe want to try to talk to you again. All right. Yeah, so you see how the horse is jumping up. He's jumping up, moving fast. He's coming in quickly. So I do see Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius here. But the thing is, the ex is not going to stay. You know, they'll come in for a little while, maybe because of the holidays. They get nostalgic, and then they'll leave again. Yeah, and I'm seeing that this person's a little bit hyper. Maybe that was the problem between y'all. He was a little bit hyper. I'm seeing that this patient was impatient. There was just like an impatient person. Could have been also a friend or a lover, not just so much an ex, you know. This card also represents other things too, not just exes. It represents a change of residence. So I'm seeing some of you are going to have a change of residence, maybe moving during the month of October. Or you're about to undertake maybe a new adventure some kind. So I'm hearing some kind of an adventure, but there is a major change approaching you. When this card comes up, it also represents a major change coming in an unexpected way, okay? So be looking out for that. All right, now this is the card that's kind of hard for you Aquariuses. This is the Empress, but it's in the reverse. This is major arcana, and you have four major arcanas here. All right, this is a court card, and this is a major arcana. I'll tell you the difference about that in a minute. Okay, so in the upright, this represents abundance and fertility. This is one of the fertility cards, baby card, okay? And then there's abundance coming because you see the wheat here is growing, so that's, you know, producing. And then the water is flowing towards the maiden, so, you know, that means everything good is flowing towards her, all right? She's holding her power stick up. Sorry, my camera stopped. She's holding her stick up, so which represents power. That she's in control of her own future. Yellow here represents, you know, a brand new day coming, and red represents passion. But it fell in the reverse, okay? So I'm seeing that there is some kind of loss, or some kind of emotional disappointment. So when the Empress in the reverse, it could represent actually losing a child or a miscarriage or losing a loved one. It also represents maybe you have inadequate income. Some of you have inadequate income, like low income due to, you know, what's happening to us. I'm also hearing environmental pollution. Some of you might be living in a place that's not so great. That's why you want to move. in December. I'm seeing a troubled marriage as well. Some of you that are married, you might be having a troubled marriage. I'm seeing dysfunction in the family or a family member, a dysfunctional family member or family setting. I'm seeing that someone needs to pay more attention to their home life. Okay, so in the reverse, it represents all those things, not just one, but all those things that I just mentioned. All right, so some of you might be having those type of problems in December. Okay, so now here we are talking about the choices. So here we have the Lovers card. This represents new love. So for some of you, Aquariuses, you're going to have new love coming in. This card literally represents the choices of in the Garden of Eden. So when it's in the upright, you see two men and two women naked. So that represents something new love. And there's a lot of sexual activity in this card. So that represents, very a lot of passion, a lot of sexual activity. So whoever's coming in, I'm seeing another Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius, or this could be you, feeling this way towards somebody else. I'm seeing new love, making choices and decisions that's higher for your good, okay? A new love interest coming in. Or maybe wherever you move to, you're gonna meet a new love interest or something like that. I do see there's gonna be harmony between you and another person. So that's not bad. You're gonna have some choices here, okay? So you can choose the ex, which probably is not a good idea, or choose the new love that's coming in. Now, for the next card, we have the Magician. So this is the two luckiest cards of all, because with the Magician, that means that you have the opportunity to manifest anything that you want to. All signs are here. We have the Pentacles, the Cups, we have the Swords, and the Wands here. So all signs are here. And again, if you notice, he's holding his stick up. This always represents power. So this shows that you have the power to manifest whatever you want because he is the Magician. And if you notice, there's an infinity sign here on top. Okay, so that means it's going to last forever. Whatever decision you make at this point is going to go on for a very long time. Now, he is standing in the color yellow, which represents brand new things coming in for you. So there is a major change coming in for you, but you got to decide what that is. You got to decide what choices you're going to make, which direction you're going to go, and you got to choose wisely. Sorry about the glare, y'all. You got to choose wisely, because whatever you choose is going to last for a very long time because the infinity sign is here. I see that you're very passionate about the direction you're going to take. Very passionate about the direction you can take because there's a red there. Now, for the next one, you have the Wheel of Fortune, which is another great card. So you're entering a lucky cycle now, Aquarius. Okay, with the Magician and the Wheel of Fortune, there's nothing that is impossible. Okay, even if you've come from dysfunction or from the ex that dumped you or whatever, nothing is impossible now because the heavens are opening up their gates. They're flowing down at you, and you're going to be able to accomplish whatever you want. With the Wheel of Fortune, I see that you could win money in the lottery if you play games of chance. You could land a new job if you apply. If you meet someone new, you could end up getting married or, things like that. So take every opportunity that comes towards you. Look at every opportunity and check it out. Don't let any opportunity pass you by in the month of December, because you could miss out on something great. Let me get a drink here. Okay, so it's looking very good. Just be careful with this ex that's coming in because they don't have good intentions. Okay, they don't have good intentions. And then this card here for some of you, if you have lost someone, I'm sorry to hear about that. If you're in a dysfunctional family, try to go to counseling, try to work it out, or just do the best you can. Okay, do the best you can because it's hard to come from a dysfunctional family. All right, so that's your reading. I mean, there's nothing really bad here except for this part here, but the rest looks great. All this looks great. The new love coming in, being able to manifest whatever you want here. And then here too, if you want to apply for a loan, do it in December because most likely you'll get it. Or if you want to buy a car, do it in December. If you want to ask your boss for a raise, do it in December because I see all that as possible in this month. All right, Aquarius, this is your reading for December 2020. Y'all, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Give me a big thumbs up. Leave your comment down below, y'all. I need some comments down there. Hit that notification bell so you'll be reminded when I upload another video. All right, y'all, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.